Madam Chairperson, I rise to speak in support of the Consumer Protection Bill 2018, which is going to replace the 33-year-old Act of 1986. Madam, every year on March 15, we observe the World Consumer Protection Day. And even in India, we observe the National Consumer Protection Day. And we chant the usual mantra of how consumer is the king. But this is not really reflected in reality. With the rise in the number of consumer complaints and how the cases are pending in the forums, in the consumer forums, there is really a need to have a new and a more dynamic law which is in tune with the changing times and needs. And especially with the growing popularity of the online purchases, we need a new law so that we are able to protect the rights of the consumers in this digital environment. I'm glad today the Honorable Minister, who's sitting right in front of me, has brought this new comprehensive bill which has all the intention of protecting our consumer rights and has several important provisions like setting up of a consumer disputes redressal commission at the district, state and national level to look into the consumer complaint, and the setting up of a central consumer protection authority to promote, protect and enforce the consumer rights as a class, and defining the unfair and restrictive trade practices, and also the establishment of a consumer protection council at the district, state and national level to render advice on consumer protection. While I understand the goodness behind all these provisions, I have certain questions related to these provisions and for which I seek clarification from the Honorable Minister. My first question relates to the Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, which are supposed to function as a civil court. Now, as the bill says, it is going to have a president and other members. But these president and members, they should be ideally having some judicial qualifications. But what the bill does not specify the minimum judicial qualifications which are to be, which these president and members should have. So what I want to understand from the Honorable Minister is that are any minimum judicial qualifications going to be prescribed by the central government or not? And if at all we are not going to have judicial officers in these redressal commissions which are going to function as civil courts, is it not violating the principle of separation of powers? My second question, Madam, relates to the Consumer Protection Council. Now, these Consumer Protection Councils are supposed to play an advisory role. They will render advice on how to protect the consumer rights better. My question here is that these consumer protection councils are going to be headed by the ministers at the state and the center and by the district collectors at the district level. Now, the ministers or the district collectors are actually the implementing authorities. So what I fail to understand is who exactly is the consumer protection counseling rendering advice to? I'm not able to understand. I want the Honorable Minister to clarify. And my third question, Madam, relates to the recommendations of the standing committee which have not been adhered to. The first one was regarding incorporating a provision to terminate a contract on the grounds of the quality of the service or the goods which are delivered, which I do not find being included under the consumer rights which have been outlined in the bill. And the second thing, a provision has not been incorporated in the bill to the effect that any misleading advertiser is being compelled to issue a corrective advertisement. So these are the three, four small issues which I want to ask the Honorable Minister. I do support this bill, but I want the Honorable Minister to clarify while he is replying to the House. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mananiya Sangsad, Sri P. Ravindranath Kumar.